Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to another session. Today we are going to talk about integrated wastewater management, Arcata Marsh. So till now, what did we discuss is about air pollution and water pollution. So if you have carefully observed, right from 1990s itself, Delhi people started struggling with air pollution. That means 1990s, you were not born and I was a child that time. So that means after these 30 years, where we stand? Are we still fighting with the same problems? Yes, we are still fighting with the same problems. And moreover, the intensity of pollution has increased. Apart from the metro cities, automobile pollution is spread to normal other towns also, two-tier and three-tier towns also. And water pollution has also been increased. So if it keeps on increasing like this, where does it end up? So we should know that there are so many technologies that are developed in order to combat with these pollutions. It's not that pollution has been increasing and increasing and increasing. It is also parallelly, we are trying to develop certain techniques. Technology is useful in combating with this air pollution or water pollution. And in today's class, we'll be trying to learn certain case studies. In our textbook, some wonderful case studies were given. Who are in these case studies, we will see how the science and technology has been applied in an eco-friendly manner to combat the pollution issues. Today, the case study is about sewage treatment in an integrated way, Arcata Marsh. Yes, environmental issues, case studies. So under the heading of case studies, there were so many case studies discussed. One is talking about management of sewage water or treatment of sewage water in an eco-friendly way. Another case study talks about solid waste management in an efficient manner. And other case studies includes plastic reusage, electronic waste management, hospital wastes, organic farming and zero wastes, radioactive waste, how do we dispose them? All these are the different varieties of concepts that are discussed under these case studies. Out of all these things, the first and most important part is about Arcata Marsh. Integrated waste management in Arcata Marsh. What is this integrated waste management and what is this Arcata Marsh? Arcata is the name of a town that is situated near California in US. So before going into the details of the Arcata Marsh, we should first know few things about the management of domestic wastewaters. So unless we know how the sewage is treated at domestic front, we cannot really understand what is this Arcata Marsh. So sewage treatments. So we all know that a lot of domestic waste is being generated in the household, in the kitchens and in the washrooms. Where do you think all this waste is going? All these wastes are being collected from our houses. They reach to the drains and from these drains, they directly reach to the sewage treatment plants. And as we all know, domestic wastewaters contains 99% of water and only just 1% will be the wastes. Just because of this 1% contamination, we are unable to use this 99% of pure water. So, and moreover, domestic wastewaters usually contain organic material. It is rich with organic material, right? So what is this? This water, the waste water that is generated from the kitchens, from the washrooms, which consists of human excreta and any other industrial waste is collectively called as sewage. Waste waters that is collected from the household or from the industrial front is called as sewage. Now, such waste, what happens to such waste? This waste cannot be directly released into the nearby water bodies. If you see in villages and in small towns, you can see that the domestic wastewater is being collected in the drains, and from drains it is directly released into the nearby pond or a lake or something, which is very, very unhygienic and unscientific. We are not supposed to release the domestic wastewater directly into the surface water bodies. This sewage water should be converted into non-toxic form by treatment. We have to first take the sewage water, divert it into sewage treatment plant. In a sewage treatment plant, all the toxic material is converted into non-toxic forms. Its organic matter content is reduced, biological oxygen demand is reduced, and then the treated water, which is almost pure, can be released into the nearby water bodies. That should be done mandatorily, right? So this sewage, what does it contain? Domestic sewage hai toh, 99.9% we have already learned is water only. And this 0.1%, what does this 0.1% contains? It contains solid particulate material, dissolved organic waste and inorganic ions, and harmful bacteria and fungi. So we have already discussed about the previous class. We have already discussed about the composition of domestic waste. In the domestic waste, composition is largely water, and the rest of it is fractionated into three parts. One is which is not dissolved, the solid particulate material like the paper, bits of paper, cloth, plastic waste, so much of material, any trash. Apart from this, organic material, the human excreta, etc., which has been in a suspended colloidal or dissolved state. So we call it as a dissolved organic waste, and inorganic ions like nitrates, phosphates, etc. Apart from this, you also have harmful bacteria and fungi. Resident microbes will be so many. So now if we want to treat such sewage water, we have to first remove the solid particulate matter, then remove the dissolved organic matter, and kill the harmful bacteria and fungi. These are the three steps we have to undertake if the sewage should be treated. Now let us see what is done in a sewage treatment plant. In a sewage treatment plant, there are the waste materials, the solid waste, the dissolved waste, and the pathogenic things. These three are dealt in at three different stages. First, all the sewage water is diverted into primary treatment stage. In the primary step, which is a physical method, all the solid particulate matter is being removed by means of filtration and sedimentation. So if you see the sewage water, you just imagine in a beaker of water, there is floating debris, there is heavy material which is settling down like sand and silt. That means there are two types of solid particulate matter. Out of these two types, the lighter ones, which are actually floating, they are removed just by filtration. Filtration is a physical method. Remember, primary stage of sewage treatment employs physical methods. So using filtration and sedimentation. So in filtration, they remove all the floating debris. And during sedimentation, they remove all the heavier particles like soil, sand, and silt. Now, once the sewage is free of solid particulate matter, it is left with all liquid which is carrying dissolved organic matter and ions. Now, this dissolved organic matter and ions, this water which is containing the dissolved matter, is called as effluent. Now, this effluent is diverted into secondary treatment. Just have a look at this slide. You can see these are the physical screens. We call them as screens or bar screens. Just like a filter, they act as, they won't allow the solid particulate matter to flow from here. Only if the pencil, paper, pen, what all we throw into the sewage, the trash will be struck over here. And only the heavier particles, sand, silt and all, along with water, will flow here. Now, once it reaches here, the arrangement is in such a way that all the heavier particles will sediment. They settle down at the bottom. Once the heavier particles sediment, the rest of the water, now this is free of solid particulate matter. So grit chamber and sedimentation tank. After water is passed through the bar screens, you call them as the bar screens, then the grit chamber and the sedimentation tank, the resultant water that is free of the solid particulate matter, this water is called as effluent. Okay. Now this effluent is carried to the secondary treatment. Now at the secondary stage, the main objective of the secondary treatment is removal of the dissolved organic matter and inorganic salts. And the fun here is we cannot use a physical method or a chemical method. Maybe by chemical method we can remove to an extent, but it is not very efficient method. Secondary stage may, the main aim of secondary treatment is to remove the dissolved organic matter and the dissolved inorganic salts. And for this treatment, no physical or chemical method is efficient enough. Then who will do this job? It is done by with the help of the resident bacteria and fungi. Already sewage is containing a lot of microbes, bacteria and fungi. Now what we are doing is all the effluent that is collected here. So here we have a lot of effluent, no? This effluent, that is the nothing but the liquid that is resulted after primary treatment, is called as effluent. This effluent is pumped into aeration tanks. Aeration tank is a large open tank. The effluent is pumped into aeration tank, and there we are artificially, mechanically supplying the oxygen. The idea here is once you spread all the water containing dissolved organic matter in a big tank and you supply oxygen continuously, the bacteria that is living in the sewage, in the sewer waters, it starts using the organic matter as a source of energy, and in the process of aerobic respiration, it will eat up all the organic matter. And for it to digest the organic matter, it needs a lot of oxygen. So what we are doing, in other words, we are trying to provide favorable conditions for the bacteria to grow in the aeration tank. Where is this bacteria present? This is already present in the sewer waters. Now the naturally present resident bacteria and fungi in the sewage is allowed to grow very well in aeration tanks. We are providing big space and we are supplying enough oxygen. So now there is space, there is oxygen, and there are nutrients in the form of dissolved organic matter. Remember, this dissolved organic matter is food for the bacteria. And why we need oxygen for them? It is just like us. When we eat food, the digested food, if we want to get ATP by breaking the food material, we need oxygen, isn't it? That is what we have learned in cellular respiration. So here also the same thing will happen. For bacteria, if it has to use this organic matter as nutrition, it also has to undergo aerobic respiration. And for this aerobic respiration to happen, it needs a lot of oxygen. That means the more organic matter it is eating, the more oxygen it has to, it should be supplied with. So in this process, during the secondary treatment, the organic matter is consumed by bacteria. Now what will happen to this bacteria? Now it is getting enough nutrients, enough oxygen, everything favorable conditions. It starts growing. It starts multiplying in bacteria. So we know bacteria is a unicellular organism. Growth itself is equal to cell division, right? So it eats and it multiplies. So gradually what happens is this effluent, which is dark and brown in color, which is containing a lot of organic matter, which was released into the, which is there in the aeration tank. After 4, 5, or 1 week of time, all the organic matter is eaten up by bacteria and all the water becomes clearer, right? And this is how indirectly bacteria is helping us to remove the dissolved organic material as well as inorganic salts. So when the effluent, when the primary effluent, after treatment of the, after primary treatment, the leftover water is called as primary effluent. When this primary effluent is released into the aeration tank, tank mein dene ke baad, at the start of the secondary process, there is high concentration of organic matter. And as a result, its biological oxygen demand will be high and dissolved oxygen will be low. But at the end of the secondary treatment, by the time the secondary treatment is completed, means this water is in the aeration tank for 4 to 6 days. All the organic matter of the effluent is reduced as it is converted to microbial biomass. So here, remember, very important, by eating the organic matter, bacteria is growing. We are calling it as organic matter is converted into microbial biomass. Conversion of organic matter into bacterial cell population is called as microbial biomass. And once all the organic matter is consumed, there is no nutrient left, hardly left. So because of that, the demand for oxygen will be reduced, means the rate at which bacteria is doing aerobic respiration is reduced because organic matter is also reduced. So BOD will be reduced. And slowly dissolved oxygen content in the secondary effluent will be increased. Okay. So here in the secondary treatment, what is the purpose of secondary treatment? To remove the dissolved organic matter. We are carefully supplying oxygen and other favorable conditions for the bacteria to grow. Now this bacteria is utilizing organic matter as nutrition, and with the help of oxygen, it is able to multiply numbers, and that is how organic matter of the effluent is reduced and biological oxygen demand is also reduced, and gradually dissolved oxygen concentration will increase by the end of the secondary treatment, and the water becomes clearer, much clearer. So as you can see here, bacteria is dancing. It is feasting on the sludge. Toxic sludge, bacteria eats the wastes and it excretes water, carbon dioxide and harmless wastes. And this is how your bacteria is playing a very significant role in the treatment of domestic wastewaters. This is secondary treatment. Now, once the water has become clear, what is the next step? So if you recollect, in your wastewater, you have solid particulate matter removed by physical treatment. Organic matter removed by biological treatment. The secondary treatment is otherwise called as biological treatment because bacteria is playing a role here. So using biological treatment, we removed all the organic matter. And what is left now? Harmful pathogenic bacteria are left. Now, those bacteria who helped us to remove the organic matter, the same bacteria is also pathogenic in nature. So we cannot leave this purified water containing harmful bacteria into the nearby river or lake. So in the third step, what do we do is, we actually go for tertiary treatment. Tertiary treatment may we have to kill all this bacteria. Disinfection, we do that, right? So just have a look at the aeration tank. This is how in a sewage treatment plant, aeration tank is there. And you can have a look at this mechanically by supplying power. And more with the help of motor, you are stirring the aeration and to provide more aeration. This encourages more growth of bacteria. Okay, now tertiary treatment, disinfection, chlorination. So once your water is clear, you have to go for tertiary treatment. In this tertiary treatment, you are using the basic method is chlorination. Using chlorination, you are killing all the pathogens and every bacteria, every microbial diet. It's not pathogen or non-pathogen, nothing like that. So now the water is clear. It is free of everything. So in the starting, we have seen sewage water is having solid particulate, dissolved organic matter and pathogens. Now all these three, with the help of this primary, secondary and tertiary treatments, all these three pollutants are removed. Once all these are removed, this water can be readily released into the nearby water body, right? So these are the steps that should take place in a sewage treatment plant for any domestic wastewater. So now you imagine all the drainage water, all the water that we generate, waste water that we generate from the household is reaching the sewage treatment plant. There it is undergoing the sewage treatment process sequentially. And once the process is over, that water is released into the nearby lake or stream. Now, based on this, we'll try to understand the Arcata marsh. So, can you tell me? Okay, this is a slide that shows all the steps that takes place in a sewage treatment plant. Primary chamber, screens or meshes, that is filtration. Then sedimentation, this is all primary treatment. Removal of the physical particulate matter using filters and sedimentation tanks. Now, primary effluent. The waters that are generated from here are called as primary effluent, reaching the aeration chamber, blowing the air here so that bacteria will grow. Now after that, the sewage water, the dark water, becomes pure water. Purification is evident that the water turned into like clear water. And here also some sludge will be generated, some sedimentation can take place. And after this purified water disinfected, and then it should be ready to be discharged. Now here, this from the primary treatment, lot of sediment is generated. Secondary treatment also, lot of sediment is generated. Okay, you're calling this sediment as a sludge. Remember, the solid material that is settling is called as sludge, and the liquid material is called as effluent. So these are the overall steps of sewage treatment, which you will be learning again in the Microbes in Human Welfare. Page number 183, Microbes in Human Welfare, mein, we will be learning about wastewater treatment in a sewage plant. Okay. This is the aerial view of a sewage treatment plant. This is the aeration tank. This is how it looks. This is the overview of a plan of a sewage treatment plant. That means everything is mechanized. We have to use a lot of power. A lot of manpower is required. This is a such STPs. Now, can you just tell me how many such sewage treatment plants are required for a town like Visakhapatnam, for a city like Visakhapatnam? For every few colonies, we should have a sewage treatment plant, isn't it? So, but do we really have those many treatment plants? No, we don't have. The irony is that we have very few treatment plants where wastes are being converted into non-toxic forms. And from certain areas, the drainage water is directly discharged into sea. If you ever visited RK Beach, it is quite evident. You can see that the sand there is quite dark in color, and you know, the sewage water pipe is directly enrooted into the sea, right? Now, let's talk about the case study. Arcata Marsh by Foam. What is this Arcata Marsh and what is this Foam? Arcata is the name of a city that is located near California. And this, it's not a city, it's actually a town. So this Arcata town, all the waste generated should be actually sent into sewage treatment plant, and it should be treated like any other town. But here, they have developed a marshland. Instead of constructing a sewage treatment plant artificially, they have constructed a natural system. And through this natural system, all the waste material is converted into useful biomass. And this marshy lands, the wetlands we call them as, they are being used to treat the waste waters from the town. And this Arcata Marsh, it's a system of wetlands. This system of wetlands is being managed by a non-government organization. Means the citizens of the Arcata town, they have formed one association called as Friends of Arcata Marsh, FOAM. And it is the responsibility of this FOAM to maintain this Arcata Marsh. That means in general, what do we do? If sewage water is being leaked, we blame the municipality. If sewage water is not treated properly, if it is directly released, we blame the municipality. We blame the government people. But here, instead of blaming anyone, all the people, they join hands together, including the corporation people, the municipal corporation people, and the public, the government sector and the public partnership, both of them together, along with biologists from Humboldt National University. So these three, there is partnership between the government enterprises, the government people, the municipal corporation people, the civic people, that means like us, the normal people, and partnership with the biologists from a particular university. So all these three people, all these three sectors, they joined hands and they developed this a system of wetlands. Now, what did they do is, they tried to collect all the wastewater at one particular point. They first treated it in a primary treatment, just like how we do. Filtration and sedimentation was done to remove all the solid particulate matter. Now, after removing it, immediately that water is treated with chlorination to kill all the pathogenic microbes. Once the water is disinfected, this water is allowed to flow in a system of wetlands, natural system of wetlands. Now, as the water is being flowing, this wetlands, this wet waters are seeded with aquatic plants, algae, different types of other bioremediation bacteria and all, so that by the time the water moves from first stage to sixth stage, all the water is getting purified on its own. This is how they have developed. So if you can see here, this marshlands are providing an integrated waste management, because it is a combination of both physical methods and biological methods. But the thing is, instead of doing it in an artificially made sewage treatment plant, it is being done in a natural system, right? Let us see how it looks. Arcata marsh is a major means of wastewater treatment. It uses basic components of the natural wetlands, soils, aquatic plants and waters as functional wastewater treatment. Bioremediation and waste treatment, floating, emergent and submerged plants will grow. Aquatic plants, roots provide nutrients to microbes to grow. So, can you identify what it is? You must be thinking it is such a beautiful scenery. It is some kind of pond or a lake, but it is not. It is the Arcata marsh. Can you believe that wastewater treatment is going on here? No. Actually, Arcata town is having open lands of 60 hectares, and these open lands are being utilized for the wastewater treatment. If you visit the web, you can find out this wetlands, wildlife and wastewater treatment in the Arcata marshes. This is the website, and it is maintained by Friends of the Arcata Marsh, FOAM, F-O-A-M, Friends of Arcata Marsh. It is nothing but a club, an association that is maintained by the citizens of the Arcata town, who are responsible to maintain this wetlands. This is called as an integrated wastewater treatment. When we use the term integrated wastewater, integrated is a term used when it is a combination of so many things, when the approach is holistic. So you can see here, Arcata town, the wastewaters including sewage can be treated in an integrated manner. Here we use the term integrated because it is a combination of both physical as well as biological, right? It's a combination of artificial and natural process. An example of such initiative is the town of Arcata, situated along the north coast of California. In collaboration with biologists from the Humboldt State University, the people of Arcata town created an integrated wastewater treatment process within a natural system. So why are we discussing this? Don't you think there is no wastewater treatment process anywhere? Everywhere there is wastewater treatment process, but here why we are discussing it is because this wastewater treatment process is designed in such a way that it works within a natural system. We don't need to pump any oxygen mechanically. We don't need to put any chemicals. We don't need to really monitor on a daily basis. It's not like any other treatment plant. So we have to discuss it. This is the aerial view of Arcata Marsh. So let us see how the sewage water in Arcata town is being treated. So it is, all the water is being collected in a 60 hectares of land area. The cleaning occurs in two stages. First stage is like a regular stage only, removal of the physical particulate matter. Remember, domestic sewage may always, the first step is removal of the particulate material. Particulate material remove karna hai to, what is the process used? Physical process. So physical process can be two types, filtration and sedimentation. Filtration is to remove the floating debris. Sedimentation is to remove the heavier particles which settles down. Now once the filtration and sedimentation is completed, this water is directly treatment for disinfection. Chlorination treatment is given. After chlorination treatment is given, all the resident bacteria are dying. Now, at this stage, lot of dangerous. So now there is no solid particulate matter, there is no pathogens. What is left here is lot of dissolved organic matter, pollutants, heavy metals, etc. Now this water, which is containing lot of pollutants, heavy metals, salts, organic matter in a dissolved state, this water is set for treatment in the natural systems. So here, the water that is free of solid matter and pathogens is flown through a series of 6 connected marshes over 60 hectares of marshland. You have already seen that it's a marshland which is containing which is of 60 hectares. And now in these stages, step by step, it is going like this. And you have appropriate plants, algae, fungi and bacteria. That means your water is flowing in 6 stages like this, like this, like this. Now at each stage, suitable algae, bacteria, fungi were seeded there so that they start using this organic matter. They start accumulating the toxic waste. They start accumulating the heavy metals, etc. And by the time it reaches from the first stage, first level to the 6th level, the whole water is purified and it is ready to be released into the nearby bay. So when the water is passed through the 6 connected marshes, the water is neutralized. Most of the organic content and toxic forms are absorbed and assimilated as the water flows through the marshes. And this is how the water gets purified. Now today, if you can see, these marshes have become a bird sanctuary, a sanctuary. That means at once that stage 1, stage 2 and stage 3 are over, from stage 4, most of the water is clearer and it has become home for growth of so many varieties of plants and all, trees, plants and all. And because of this, whenever there is thick vegetation, naturally, lot of birds will be attracted and so many other animals are also attracted. So today, the Arcata Marsh is also having a bird sanctuary in it. Can you just imagine the place where wastewater is being treated? It is the same place where people visit for its biodiversity, to see plants, animals, etc. So it has high level biodiversity in the form of fish, animals, birds who reside in those marshy lands. And this Arcata Marsh is maintained by a citizens group called Friends of Arcata Marsh Foam. They are responsible for the upkeep and safeguarding of this wonderful project. So in general, what happens at our places, there will not be any such initiation or innovation. And by chance, if there is somebody who is able to innovate and initiate the process, once the process has started, there will be nobody to take charge of it and maintain it constantly. But here, the Friends of Arcata Marsh is nothing but the citizen group. It is a non-government organization and they have taken up the responsibility to keep up the marshlands in a better state and to safeguard this particular project. So, friends, don't you think it is wonderful to have a sewage treatment plant in a natural system? And it is this kind of solutions we need at this point of time. So this is the emblem, Friends of the Arcata Marsh Foam. This is one miniature setup of wetlands. If you can see this carefully, mechanical clarification, removal of all the physical material. And after that, it is being flown like this. So here the marshlands are also almost like this only. One stage, stage 2, like steps, stage 3, stage 4 and stage 5. So you can see here, at each stage, different kind of plants are being seeded. So here you can see the suspended solids, biological oxygen demand and organic nitrogen and phosphate are removed with the help of these plants. Percolation, water is sinking here. And then vertical flow. Here water is allowed to flow. Phosphates, again BOD, nitrogen, nitrification, removal of so many unwanted things. And then horizontal substrate flow from this stage to this stage. Different variety. Rooted plants, submerged plants are growing. Again, floating hydrophytes. Again, submerged hydrophytes. So all these are the different interconnected wetland systems. Almost this kind of setup you will find there in the Arcata marsh also. It's a multi-stage constructed wetland system that can be used for organic matter and phosphate removal. Okay. So stage B, C and D may duckweed, water hyacinth are being grown. And stage D may emergent hydrophytes, means those hydrophytes which are rooted here and which are growing above the surface of the water. And then these wetlands also can be designed for nitrification and metal removal from waters. So this is one ideal example, and we are also supposed to adopt such ideal scenarios for our conditions and make them suitable for our conditions. So what do you think is better? Running an artificial sewage treatment plant with lot of power input is better, or to manage the sewage treatment in such natural systems? So it's up to you. Future is yours. Almost like this. So this is about your Arcata marsh and integrated waste management. Don't you think it's wonderful? Yes, at least for me it is very wonderful. Now, we'll talk about another new concept that has come up, that is ecological sanitation. In short, it is called as EcoSan. So all this time, ecological sanitation ke bare mein, before this, when we are talking about this Arcata marshes, we are saying that most of the domestic wastewaters are carrying 99% of water. And the problem here is to remove, to separate this large amounts of water from this little amount of the waste material. Okay? The problem here is, out of this 100% of waste, if this is 50% of waste and 50% of water, that would have been a different issue. But here, 99.9% is water, just water. Only for this 0.1% of waste material, we have to put all this effort to purify the water. Now, there came up a new concept. According to this new concept, we generate dry waste. How can we generate dry waste? That is the question here. And if we are able to generate the waste material from the domestic front in a dry manner without mixing of water, then it becomes easier for us to deal with this dry matter, and the amount of sewage generated will be very less. So for every 100 kgs, if it is 99 kgs is water and only 1 kg is organic waste, how to deal with it? It's on a large scale, it's a different issue. But if we are able to generate just this 1 kg of waste material without mixing with water, it becomes easier for us to deal and to manage the waste. And that is how the concept of ecological sanitation has come up. So if you can read this, these are the textbook lines as it is. All this time, we have assumed that removal of waste requires water. That means we are creating sewage. Sewage is nothing but water in combination with waste materials. But what if water is not necessary to dispose of the human waste like excreta? If we don't have to flush the washroom, it is just excreta that is left. So how do we deal with it? That is called as dry toilet concept, right? Can you imagine the amount of water that one can save if one did not have to flush the toilet? Well, this is already a reality. Don't imagine that you don't flush the washroom and just come out like that. That is not the case here. It's something different. Just hold your breath and listen carefully. Okay? Ecological sanitation is a sustainable system for handling human excreta using dry composting toilets. So here, by this time, you should have understood the concept. What is the concept here? The human excreta should not be mixed up with water, right? So, but still, how do we dispose it off? That is the question. This is called as dry toilets. This is a practical, hygienic, efficient, and cost-effective solution to human waste disposal. The key point to note here is that with this composting method, human excreta can be recycled into a resource. It reduces the need for chemical fertilizers. And that is how they came up with the dry toilet concept called as EcoSan. Okay, so before knowing the advantages and its importance, let us see what is this dry toilet concept first of all. So this is the design of a dry toilet. What are you supposed to do? You're supposed to just sit on the commode, just release whatever you want to release. And after that, you have to just put some sawdust or whatever material was there, ash or something will be kept. And you have to just put into that hole and close the lid. Now under this, what is there? This excreta is being, this chamber is designed in such a way that some amount of reactions happen here. And this excreta over a period of time is converted into a compost, and the converted compost is released into this particular chamber. So here you can see the concept of dry toilet is that after the excreta is released, we are not going to flush. We are just adding some sawdust or ash, whatever material was there. You have to add it and then close the lid. And then what happens? This is reaching to a chamber where it undergoes the decomposition process. And the chamber is designed in such a way that decomposition takes place at a very quicker rate. So many other materials are also added here. And after decomposition, this excreta is converted into a compost. And once the compost is done, the compost is being collected into another chamber. And now this compost can be used in the place of a chemical fertilizer. This is the concept, right? So don't you think this is a better option? So this concept is simply called as dry toilets, right? So this dry toilets, the EcoSan toilet, we call it as ecological sanitation. The concept here is not to mix up the human excreta with the water. So here it is reaching to the farmer in the form of a compost and fertilizer. So another thing, first one is we are able to reduce the amount of wastewater generated. That is the first advantage. Second advantage is we are able to convert the excreta into compost. That is the second advantage. And third major advantage is because the compost is organic in nature, it doesn't cost much and it doesn't cause environmental pollution in turn. If you know, chemical fertilizers also cause a lot of pollution to the environment. So there are so many such advantages, right? So this is another poster that shows how to use EcoSan toilets. See, the person has come. He opened the lid, then finished off the work, and then added the sawdust or the ash, then replaced the lid, and then of course need to wash hands before leaving the toilet. Here we have to use a tissue. We are not supposed to use water. Okay. This sounds a little awkward, but it is actually eco-friendly, and we are supposed to adopt it. Conversion. The modern way to save the resources and recycle the waste for a cleaner and hygienic environment. EcoSan toilet ka tagline is modern way of ecological sanitation to save resources, to recycle the waste and for a cleaner and a hygienic environment, right? And in which states they are currently operational? They are currently operational in the Kerala and Sri Lanka. Okay. This is the concept of ecological sanitation. So I hope you enjoyed this session, and in next session we will be talking about other wonderful case studies. That's all for the day. Goodbye.